And there it is, the final whistle, and they're out. It's all over. Oh, it's a sad moment, this. Who would want to be a football manager?
Thanks very much for turning up today. What we're making today is a small promotional video for our cafe. Now, let's get this clear. You do know about other sports apart from football, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Fine, I'll leave you to it then.
This is Joe Jordan's vest, which he probably wore under his lead shirt.
Which is fair enough because, you know, it was a lot colder in the 70s because they still had a bit of ozone layer left then, so it was quite chilly, especially up north.
Now, hold on.
Now, this is World Cup Willy's anorak.
No, it's a speed skater.
I remember there was this exhibition of World Cup memorabilia, right, somewhere in South London. This is a true story. I saw a leaflet for it, and it had, as an exhibit, what it described as a life-size model of World Cup Willy. How big is that, then?
About that size.
Nah, but that's one of them stretchy things, isn't it? I mean, it could be anything.
Look, I don't think this video's going very well.
Nah, it's all right. All it needs is a few funny clips to warm it up.
News this week that Juventus plan to buy French international Baddiel Boli, probably the most excitable player in Europe. Here he is, slightly querying a ref's decision.
The only person more excited than Baddiel Boli this week was a contestant from Gladiators, who, unfortunately for him, had turned up in completely the wrong place.
And despite being spat at this week, Graham Taylor was cheered up when he received the royalties for sales of his book, How to Be a Successful International Manager.
And following up allegations that Howard Kendall was sacked for being a very heavy drinker, the Notts County Board have now provided evidence that his behaviour in the dugout was completely unacceptable.
After the stress of long-time unemployment, Mike Walker was delighted at the reception he got at a Norwich City Supporters Club meeting last Tuesday.
He looks well on it. Alan Shearer was very disappointed on Boxing Day when the linesman beat him in the most camp expression of the game competition.
Oh, he beat him hands down.
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
With the current trend for booking players for celebrating goals, strikers have to be very careful about other people leading them on.
Oh.
You're Inside Right with your host, Bruce Forsyth.
Hello and welcome. Ins to see you, to see you. Hello and welcome to Play Your Inside Right. The wife's too young and the jokes are shite. Here's a header. And here's a volley. It's time to meet my dishy dolly.
That's your dishy dolly!
Right. So, no, don't go away, give us a bit of a twirl, because you look absolutely fantastic. Oh God, I could just, and let's face it, I usually do. So, okay then, Robbie Earl, Steve Bowl, Dave Besant, can we have our first contestant? Oh, welcome! Please, girl, do get me on the podium. Thank you very much, Mr. Dolly.
Hello, Brucey.
Hello, and you are?
Jimmy Hill.
Oh, Jimmy Hill? Jimmy Hill sounds like a piece of high ground where people go for a piss.
What a good remark.
Yes, now, you wouldn't think that this would come off and the hair stay on, would you? But stop.
You wouldn't think you were Leonard Rossiter, are you?
No, my God, no. What do you do, Jimmy? Never mind. Now, we have actually asked. Now, this is a very tough question, but brace yourself. Thank you, because we both have the same. We asked 100 Alan Hansons which of his fellow TV pundits would he most like to punch in the face, right?
Well, obviously, it's a me.
Yeah.
But you could have only asked one Alan Hansen.
No, we only asked one Alan Hansen, but he said he would like to punch you 100 times.
What a good remark.
Oh! OK, let's play. You're Inside Right! So here's your first card. Now, let's hope it's a good one for you.
Oh.
And it's United. Now, will the next team be higher or lower?
Oh, well, obviously, for many seasons, I was saying to Eric Cantona that if he was going to leave Leeds United, then they probably...
Look, is it higher or is it lower?
Well, really, lower.
No, you choose your... You choose, so here we go, and here we are, and...
Yeah!
This is lower. It is higher. Higher than Tottenham Hotspur. That is so unlucky. But you do get another chance, What you need now is something really high, right?
Really high.
Yeah! Ryan Gunter! Well, that's very... Isn't that high? That's very high indeed. And I think talk.
I think it'll definitely be higher.
Higher than Brian... Higher. What do you think? Is it higher or...?
Higher
than Brian Gunter! Well, let's say higher than Brian...
Yeah!
Well done, so it's this one. For the car,
I've predicted many seasons
now.
And I think now, lower.
Okay.
Lower. Definitely. Oh!
Oh! That's very bad luck because you get nothing from Eclair. Now this, obviously, is Fitzroy Simpson's football shirt.
He don't look that big on the telly, does he?
No, no, I'll make it more obvious for you. He is a footballer, but not British. He's very famous. He's done everything. Adverts, the lot. But recently his career has been marred by allegations of terrible violence.
Well, it's Cantona's shirt.
What do you see?
A black man?
A Frenchman?
A Scotsman?
An old pisshead?
It's a serious advert.
Is it okay
to hurl abuse at us just because we do sport in question?
Yes, it is.
Oh. Okay. Some people say...
When seagulls follow the trawler, it's because they think sardines will be thrown into the sea.
Some people say...
Hello, I'm Victor Kayam.
Well, only Victor Kayam, really.
I am...
What?
Graham Kelly.
Oh.
I'm not, obviously. The big question is...
If they're gonna make adverts like this...
What's the point...
...of paying £87 for a colour
TV licence?
I'd rather play football.
What did you think about
it? I thought it was appalling. I thought it was terrible. I thought it was tragic. But most of all, I thought it was very, very funny. It's just... comfortably the best thing that's happened this season. Absolutely brilliant.
It was fantastic.
Totally yeah, brilliant. It was great.
We had a bit of an all-night celebration last night.
What do you think he actually said, the Crystal Palace fan, to him? I mean, presumably it was something worse than, you know, you silly Frenchman. Or
I think he might have slagged off the Marseillaise or something like that. Who knows?
Said you make a very poor orange sauce. You a rugby fan, Statter?
Well, I like the internationals. It was the start of the Five Nations, of course, last weekend. That was great with Ireland and England. Conditions were pretty
boring,
bad there.
Boring, Stato! Boring,
oh,
boring, boring,
oh,
mate.
Oh, he's turned.
You're out of order, mate. You are.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Hey, come on.
I got Cantona.
Yeah.
Who has been very temperamental for my...
Have you seen he's wearing his collar up all
now,
the time?
I don't like that attitude. Arsenal talented player who scores goals.
Yeah.
I spent £9 million on him and give him a nice little bungalow as well. What do I get? Sod all from Le Grand Eric de France. As far as I'm concerned, Eric, I know as a manager this is not perhaps a thing to say for team spirit, is to slag off your number one buy, but I'm thinking of playing him in goal.
Now, this is a football thing, so you'll be all right with this one.
Yeah, this is an autographed England shirt. You can see that it's been signed by Trom Clag. Yeah. He signed it.
And Mix O Millie.
Yeah, he was quite good in his day. There's Baldy George.
Yeah.
He was bald. An older player, but.
Yeah. I'll tell you, his name won't be on this shirt, though. If you're watching Terry Venables, please, please, please pick Matthew Letizia for England. Don't listen to dry old Alan Hansenisms like commitment and consistency. That's poppycock. What you want is beauty. I know he's got a big ass. I know he looks like he couldn't give a toss, but that's good. Like all great players, his is a nonchalant grace. He plays like an angel alongside Francis Benali. What dreams could he weave with Paul Gascoigne? It was Graham Taylor who put him on the bench once, but didn't play him, who chose to start instead with Jeff Thomas. I'm a realist, Taylor thought, but turns out he was wrong. It's actually poetry that wins matches. Remember Terry, Stan Bowles, Alan Hudson, Peter Osgood, Rodney Marsh, Laurie Cunningham, all geniuses, all hardly capped. Don't add Letitia to that list. As you may or may not know, what little writing is done on this show is by me and Frank. We do occasionally get ideas sent in for sketches, but, you know, they're always about Jurgen Klinsmann diving.
Oh, Man United changing their kit.
Gary Mabbott's eye.
Wimbledon playing the long ball game.
Arsenal being boring.
Or stuff about me shagging Michaela Strachan.
No, you sent that one in.
Oh, yeah. Did I write the one about you shagging Gordon Strachan?
No. No, I wrote that one. But tonight we've decided to showcase the work of an up-and-coming young sketch writer whose agent got in touch with us.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that'll be him now, I should think.
This'll be him. And he's written a sketch for us, so let's get him in here. It's Matthew Letitia.
Oh! Oh, she's very excited. I'm sorry?
Scummer!
Who's this? Who's this bloke?
I feel you're overdoing the scummer remark. Somewhat.
I thought this was based on the Premier League.
Now, let's do it. I think we should do it.
OK.
Yeah, OK, give us a script.
Have you got a set for this,
Stato, get us a set for this. That's lovely, the video shop sketch. OK, and just, let's get this right.
And everything.
Let's get this right.
It's all professionally done.
It is.
Your cue to come in is whatsoever.
That's the one.
Whatsoever. All right, then. OK, there's the video shop. Let's get going.
Right.
Stato.
The video shop, take one.
Cor, blimey, Frank. That walk from our house to here was longer than a Wimbledon clearance.
Come back, come up. I'm buying you a video as a special birthday present.
What about this one? The Arsenal video.
That would be very boring. Does anything else catch your fancy?
Let's see.
This one.
They seem to be glued together in some way. What about this one?
Oh, that must be the Jurgen Klinsmann story.
You see, oh, look! Here's a history of Manchester United. And there's another coffee. And another coffee.
You're storming it, Matt. You're absolutely storming it back here. Well, it says on the back here, Manchester United, a big club, but a bit too far from Guernsey for my liking.
Hang on, I've seen this one. This one's broken.
Oh, I think that's the Gary Mabbott one. Oh, we can't do this material, can we?
Hold on, what's this one? Skinner Strachan antics?
Actually, I wouldn't mind that one.
Whatsoever!
Is this what you're looking for?
This is what I'm looking for.
Right, Barry, Gazza, Peter, thanks a lot for coming to this England get together.
Cheers, boss.
Yeah, cheers, boss.
Now, Now, as you all know, we've got no games. We've got no games.
You see, with a ball, I'm good. With a door, I'm shit. Yeah.
As you know, we got no games this summer. I personally would have preferred it if we'd had to be in the qualified rounds for the European Championship.
Well, yeah, but then we'd have no games next summer. You see, we wouldn't have qualified.
Yeah, thank you, Matthew. Now, these get-togethers are. They're very, very important, and, no, don't sit there. You know I only like one man up front.
I hate him. He don't pick you, but he pick on you.
Now, as you can see, as we all know, players have got commitments. There's a few empty seats.
Yeah, it looks a bit like the Uruguay game.
Look, if you don't like him, why don't you play for bloody Guernsey? Hey? These get-togethers are a very important part of my overall team-building process.
So? What do we do now, boss?
What about a nice game of pontoon?
Is that like Gambit with Fred Dinage and Michelle Lambourne?
I like Buckaroo! Snap!
Oh, heck, I thought it was my knee gone again.
Are you bloody Fred Gazza?
Look, you're not here to play stupid games. You'll be bringing your Barbie dolls in next. No offence, Barry. What we're trying to do here, we're trying to organise ourselves into a well-disciplined, super-efficient machine.
What about a game of I Spy, then?
Oh, all right, then, I'll start. I spy with my little eye...
Ooh, 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 Gary Mabuch!
No, Peter, I haven't started yet. Something beginning with T.
Boss, boss, boss! Manager!
T?
Table.
T.
No. Trainer.
Close, Gazza, very close.
Manager.
T. T.
Is it tactics that are going to lose us the European Championship?
Out. Go on. Get out.
I was just joking.
No. Out.
I wanted a sort of free roll.
Get out. I won't have players in here who can't keep their mouths shut. No, Peter, I didn't mean players who can't keep their mouths shut. I just meant, you know, talking.
You're going to make new beginnings and a change and that. You're just the same as Graham Taylor.
Oh, don't talk stupid. God, do I not like Matt?
The most capped Welsh international.
Looks nothing like Ian Rush.
Yeah, but who does, eh?
John Aldridge.
True.
Now, the idea of a man giving birth might sound ridiculous, but we would like to thank Mr. Lyle Gurley of Falkirk. Of Falkirk, I'm sorry, I'm drunk. for drawing our attention to the news that even more miraculously, Stato has now had a baby.
Oh, how Christmassy as well. They have virgin birth. Marvellous.
Paul Merton was in the evening with Gary Lineker, wasn't he?
He was, yeah.
Eventually. Didn't take your part, he took another part.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, but we were watching Southampton versus Spurs the other day.
Oh,
and
yeah.
We thought we saw Paul Merton in the crowd reading a newspaper. There he is.
David grew a moustache and got voted onto the West London Synagogue Board of Deputies.
We get sent a lot of stuff of people saying that they've spotted all sorts of people in all sorts of places. Andy and Sue Parler from Clacton. Are they related to Ray Parler?
It's actually Ray Parler's cousin is Andy Parler. That's true.
All right. Well, anyway, searching their attic, what they came across was this photo. They were looking for, you know, their grandparents or something like that, but they came across this photo of Stato.
So,
have you still got the dress? Or?
Yeah, much better now, isn't it?
Well, as you say, he's a lovely bloke, Ian Robson, if you know, lovely bloke. Yeah, the nice thing about him is that his mum goes to all his matches.
Really?
Yeah. There's Ewan, there. And there's his mum, there. As Frank says, we do get a lot of lookalikes sent in every week for me, for some reason, but as we said, we never get any for Frank. No one seems to look like him. But then finally... Well, he's not upset about it or anything. It's not a saddening thing.
Well, I pretend not to be, but...
Well, cheer up, Frank, because Chris Tipping from Leighton Buzzard has finally sent in this bloke who saw at a Republic of Ireland game. There he is, sort of Frank Skinner's idiot brother.
And I'm with your dad, by the looks of it.
You are. It's good, though.
Now, this cabinet traces the development of the goalkeeping glove.
Have you ever thought that if goalkeepers grew their fingernails really, really long, they could wear really, really long gloves?
It's a thought.
Change everything, wouldn't you? I mean, Arsenal would have won the Cupman's Cup for a start-off.
I played in goal once. Someone told me I looked like the Mexican World Cup goalkeeper Campos.
You sure they didn't tell you looked like compost?
Anyway, now we've been joined here by two other fanatical fans of the game, Frank Skinner and David Baddiel, with their alternative look at the World Cup. Gentlemen, what are you making of it?
I had a strange incident the other night when the phone went during a German game, and as I brushed past the telly, Klinsmann fell over. And apparently now I've got to miss the South Korean game on Monday night, so I was very upset about that.
Now, you two have been doing something that Gary here and the rest of the boys do all the time, picking out
Thailand.
Hello, tonight the World Cup is coming to terms with the biggest drug scandal in its history. 6 years ago, the world of sport went into shock when Ben Johnson tested positive after winning the 100 metres in Seoul. Now, in another sport, a name as big as Johnson has also been caught out and labelled a cheat. It's a word not unfamiliar to Maradona already, but this time it almost certainly means the end of a talent recognised to be on a similar plateau as Pelé and Cruyff. Well, it's been serious stuff all the way today, but stand by for a half-time tonight, which will include fantasy fun from Skinner and Baddiel. It started already. And also from fantasy football, Skinner and Baddiel. Anyone in particular influenced you during the tournament?
No, not really.
Not especially, no.
Stoichkov's been very good.
Who?
Stoichkov's been very good.
Oh, he's good, yeah.
Just a final thought on that Bulgarian victory today from the fantasy boys. Sad for Germany, lads?
Yeah, I think I can speak for everybody to say that we're absolutely gutted that the Germans have gone out. It's a terrible, terrible thing. Only the rest of the world's going yabba-dabba-doo at this very moment.
Of course, the biggest award in the World Cup is the World Cup itself. Now, we can't all be World Cup winners, but, you know, it's quite easy to make your own World Cup at home. Isn't it, Stato? Right, all you need is a normal-sized cantaloupe or melon that you can buy in any grocer's shop, there it is. Not very expensive. And a large bucket of custard. Here it comes, lovely. Now, you take the cantaloupe in your right hand, quite firmly, right? And you plunge it elbow deep into the bucket of custard. Go on, get it in there. Haven't said that for a few months. So there it is, right? And so let it soak for a bit, let it marinate, as it were. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, presto, the World Cup.
Oh, I'll get it.
Sorry, that's too many people turning up here
it's
tonight.
It's busy, isn't it, tonight? Oh, hello. Right. It's that Italian bloke who was at the party last night. Said he... No, he said he's left his shirt.
Oh, well, let him in.
I shall get him in.
Yeah,
come in, mate. Got his shirt. You step out and I'll
get the shirt out.
Not easy, is it?
You all right?
Typical, isn't it? You come all the way to Norway to meet Halvar Torreson, and then he doesn't even turn up.
Hold on a minute, isn't that him? Halvar!
Halvar! We thought this would be a good place to be the England end!
I know, but I'm Norwegian! I'm not allowed to go that close to the opponent's goal.
Well, Halvar.
Hello, Halvar.
Halvar, we're here to recreate the goal you scored against England in the World Cup qualifier in Oslo in 1981. What do you remember about that game?
England took an early lead. Incredibly, we equalised. And then 5 minutes later, Ekland made a bad cross as usual. Terry McDermott served the ball to me and I just had to kick it in the net.
Och så är det 2-1 med Halvar Torreson. Fantastisk utveckling av kampen. 2-1 till Norge.
Right, well, thanks very much, Halvar. It was a nice meeting you.
Hold on. You didn't come all this way for a tired old joke about Norway being defensive?
Yes, we did.
Really? We did, yeah.
Well, you've been listening too much to Tom Webster. I'm talking about commentators.
Just not England. England. Lord Nelson. Lord David Bruce. Sir Winston Churchill. Sir Anthony Eden.
Clement Attlee, Henry Cooper, Lady Diana, Maggie Thatcher, can you hear me? Maggie Thatcher, you boys took a hell of a beating. You boys took a hell of a
no,
beating.
No, that's what you should recreate.
Lord Nelson, Lord David, Sir Winston Churchill.
Where on earth is Lord Beaverbrook?
Ah, here he comes now.
Gary Mabbott?
Sir Anthony Eden, Clement Attlee, Henry Cooper.
That's for the Suez Crisis.
Lady Diana, Maggie Thatcher, can you hear me?
Yeah, well, the thing is, Ron Greenwood should have listened to Margaret Thatcher. She's been studying videos of Norway games. Anyway, I must dash. I have to be photographed leaving a health club.
Hold on. I haven't told you about the time we beat Holland.
You're Steph Holland! Oh, Vincent van Gogh! His finger in the dike! Martina da Vandalora! Oh no, that's wrong. That guy! It's Sylvia! Oh, what were they called? Focus! That's them! Jules Holland, probably! And Julep! Some prostitutes! The mouse who lived in the windmill! Dick van Dyke! Can you hear me? Dick van Dyke! Your boys took one hell of a beating! Your boys took one hell of a beating!
And with Swindon apparently facing the drop from Division 1, manager Steve McMahon admitted that he's slightly concerned about the effect this is having on attendances.
Keep looking, Steve. Some Palace fans here saying, look, good gate to me. Now, you know when you did something really, really rubbish and then you're trying to pretend it never happened? Well, here's Rule Fox. Like he was saying, no, I was just joking, obviously.
Strangely, in a season where Southampton fans have been let down an awful lot, one fan has come out and pleaded to be let down a bit more. He just couldn't quite reach it, could he?
You have to let him down very slowly or he'll be out that ground, that lightning. Now, a lot of people say Cantona had it coming. They say he was asking to be sent off against Blackburn on Sunday.
Now, let's get one thing clear. These are Sally Gunnell's shoes.
Yeah, they should have had a vest as well.
Yeah, because then she'd be the fastest Gunnell in the vest. Look, you're not going to get too far in the wide, wide world of sport with terrible jokes like that.
Oh, I don't know.
Manchester City are now pressing. They're so pressing, they're almost urgent.
You're a ronk Man United fan.
A what?
Ronk means, you know, extreme Man United fan.
Well, yeah, I mean, in fact, can I just flash that off? Because that's a little souvenir. Bobby Charlton testimonial programme that my older... It's our Tony's. So if you're watching Tony, you thought my mum had chucked it out with all the rest of the stuff. I nicked it and put it with me, mine and our Kev's comics.
that's probably the best programme you've ever been involved with.
Having a fine season, Ian Rush, he really does continue to produce the goods at the highest level.
You know that Barbican, that alcohol-free lager?
I do.
Laurie McMenemy advertised. I don't think Ian Rush drinks that, does he?
I think you'd better ask the gaffer about that. He seems to do everything else, so it's up to him. I don't think you've asked him, so think he just asked him to tell us to get us an album. The way he's had the seasons anyway, before his son come out.
Have you ever had Jimmy Hill on the bed, Paula?
No, I haven't.
I'd have thought he would be perfect.
I've had Les Ferdinand.
Have you?
Not the same bloke, though, is it? By a long chalk.
What was he like?
He was fantastic. He had a purple suit on with matching underpants and socks.
Matching underpants? How did you know that?
Because he wanted me to see that it was all matching.
Right.
As you do. Duh.
Sorry, so he actually took his trousers off?
No, he just pulled his waistband up.
All right. Mm.
Cool. You've got me going, Paul. Blimey.
Calm down, we might have to use another string in a minute.
I so...
I think we've got a shot of Eddie on the bench, haven't we? Have we got... There he is. Yeah. Right, there he is.
Oh, there he is,
with
yeah.
the perm, you've just been criticising in other people. Actually.
Yeah, but that was of its day, wasn't it?
And that is David Pleat, actually, oh, about to set off.
Yeah, I remember that day. You can see how happy I am, can't you?
Yeah.
This is such a... Have we got David Pleat running? Because that is such a brilliant football moment.
Yeah,
oh,
there
look at him. Whoa, look at him go.
This is when Luton put Man City
Luton
down.
Luton put Man City down, I remember it well.
What a fantastic Indian-like run, red Indian-like.
Peter Swales was chairman that day.
And...
as Brian Horton.
Yeah. And we'll all be hugging Brian Horton when
City
get relegated in the past 6 months.
In the old days, you used to just sort of scribble in your post-match analysis with the telestrator, right? But now it's the graphics are getting really flash on Match of the Day. Now, here's a clip of you at work.
He hits it a little bit too far there, but he's got three options. He can hit it, go straight for goal, he can play it between defender and goalkeeper, and he can play it back to Mike Newell, who was circled.
You see, this is why I've fought long and hard to get arrows in the programme. Yeah. Arrows and circles, and you've destroyed it again.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hansen soft drinks. Unbelievable. Soft drinks, that's a bit boring, isn't it?
Well, it is Hansen's soft drinks.
Yeah, but even so, it's a bit of a weird combination, Scottish and non-alcoholic.
Well, Scottish and ex-alcoholic.
What do you mean?
Satan, creepy talk about the Exley League as if it's important. Satan, creepy talk about the Exley League as if it's important.
So, say, it's been an incredible week as far as football's concerned.
I'll say, Jimmy, I mean, that story about David Kelly of Championship contenders Wolves being suspended, as you may know, he'll now miss games against the big three, Reading, Oldham and, of course, the mighty Charlton.
No, say, I was actually talking about off-the-field events.
Oh, hey, that's an incredible story.
I mean, Stuart Webb getting on the board at Derby 3 years after leaving the club.
I shudder to think what the tabloids will make of that one, eh?
Why haven't we got Premier League football, say? When's it coming back?
Jack!
What is it, Stan?
What?
What is it?
Oh, right, sorry. Yeah. I had a... That's a bit of your mouthful. I had a good night with that new Clippy last night. Yeah, that's the one.
Oh, she's gone home. Been feeling sick in the mornings.
Nothing.
It's not her.
Must have been wrong.
I'm starving, actually. Yeah. Oh, dear. Got any, want some? Yeah. Stuffed olive?
Not yet, but it'll follow.
Oi. That's it, Jerry. We're out of the cup and that's that.
Oh, no, Mr. Sugar. I mean, what am I going to tell the lads? They've been preparing for this for months.
You'll just have to break it to them gently.
from South Africa, isn't he?
That's bad news, but I will break it to him gently. Now, look, lads.
Don't worry, Jerry. We've got the song all sorted. All right, Dave?
Yep.
There we go. Right.
See, I think there might have to be a few minor alterations.
That's all right. It don't matter.
Well, tell you what. Play us what you got so far. We'll see how it goes.
Okay. Here we go, boy. Here we go. Right.
Spurs are on their way to Wembley.
Hold it. That's the first problem, I think, that one. what do you think, boss?
What about aunt?
Give it a go, right? Here we go, Dave. 3, 4.
Spurs are on their way to Wembley.
If only there was somewhere else we was on our way to.
Well, we got Norwich on Monday.
Spurs are on their way to Norwich.
Oh, I like it.
No,
hold it. Lads. Jerry. We're at home to Norwich.
Spurs are on their way to Tottenham.
Do you want this job or not?
Calm down. Now, look, let's leave the chorus for a bit, right? Leave the chorus and just what you got planned for the rest of the song?
We got that going. Here we go. All right, Dave. All right. Here we go.
Jürgen's gonna Wembley. His knees are
going. You see, that is essentially the same problem.
Yeah.
Jürgen is not going to Wembley. No.
Surely someone can get him a ticket.
Well, we could ask Cluffy.
Come on. It's just not going to work.
Sorry, Ben.
Hang on. Yeah. No, don't worry about it. Don't worry about that. Right, we've got it. Here we go. Right, okay.
Palace loopy nuts are we? Let's go to Wembley. Football was rubbish, old football just wasn't very good.
Bit of a poor attendance at this game, just everybody in the whole country.
Yeah, but incredibly, they only sold 15 tickets. Might be why.
This is how people got to matches, and in a second the driver says, "Hey lads, we're at the ground."
Some of the poor people had to walk so far to the game that their bodies couldn't come to terms with the fact they'd actually arrived at the ground. Now, this woman is a streaker. They were a bit rubbish in those days. And, a bit more conservative than your modern streaker.
Oh, end-to-end stuff. Half-time. Oh, we're off again.
There's the crowd rushing to look at another streaker.
And there he is.
The kinkiest sign of the zodiac is said to be Virgo.
You're joking.
No, it's not you, you're Aquarius. Aren't you?
Is that John Virgo?
Do you know Virgo? Fantastic! Is it John Virgo? He said brilliant. Oh, dear.
Oh, the best moment.
Sato, I've never done that before.
Have some victory ale, mate.
He'll be drunk and naked in a minute.
Can we get special dispensation for Stato to do a ho-ho?
Go on, Stat.
Ho-ho.
West Brom played Dynamo Bucharest at the... true, at the Hawthorns in... Or when would it be? Early 70s. This is a true story.
And Dynamo Bucharest turned up, and the Albion disc jockey who ran Radio Throstle from the stand.
That's a disease.
Not a joke. They couldn't get a copy of the Romanian national anthem. So when they stood up for the national anthem, they played Midnight in Moscow by Kenny Bourne.
Honestly.
Oh,
wonderful.
Honestly, all standing there bravely. We've gone one further because we have actually got you, at great expense, I might point out, a Ryan Giggs duvet cover. And there he is. It's a lovely. Isn't that nice?
And there he is making the face that I make when I'm under my duvet. Like Ray Stubbs, whenever he pronounces his name, he pronounces it Peter and Love, like Barry, like Barry White.
5 minutes to go after great work by Peter and Love. Peter and Love turned inside Keith Curl. A marvellous solo effort to Peter and Love.
Hello, I'm Graham Kelly.
Goes north. It is much better than going May West.
Hello.
Oh, it's a smoothie.
Peter and Love. Talking and Love. He plays for Coventry. It's Peter and Love.
It's all right, Ray. All right, mate.
There's more. Tram me for the playoffs. Tram me for promotion.
Yeah, you spoiled it now. Great stuff. Great
One thing I don't think is fair about Beardsley is he gets a lot of stick for what he looks like, and actually he's got quite an ordinary face, really. He's not like, you know, it's true. He's not hideous to look at.
To be honest, I saw a photo of Beardsley the other day. I didn't even notice his face.
That's scandalised.
That was Beardsley sitting on Ian Dowie's shoulders.
I'm so upset. That never happens when I go to matches.
You're about third from bottom.
I am. Yeah. Doing rather well with the thugs, aren't I?
You are, actually.
Yeah. I think you just pick them on whether or not they go to jail.
You think I'm going to go down?
Yeah.
Any time, Damon.
Actually, I think we've got a clip here of the Sun's dream team.
He's the perfect defender, actually, for Fantasy League, because he plays for a team that don't let many goals in, and
no,
God, is there?
Someone at the door.
It's not Danny Turwin.
It's
Terry Venables.
Yes. Sorry about this, someone turning up like this.
Oh, heck, it's David Pleat.
This is a snooker cue signed by all the players on the opening day of the Dubai Desert Classic.
How come Willie Thorne's name is Nonny?
Well, they signed it at lunchtime and he'd gone home by then.
Stop buying me crap Christmas presents.
What do you mean?
What I mean, and I think you know, is this video, Best of Friends, the official story of Gary Lineker and Willie Thorne.
No, that is a very, very fine present.
No,
the official story, not the thousands of bootleg copies that are knocking about.
And all sorts of nonsense.
And you get this with it.
Yeah, but it's
I've
rubbish.
I've had that over my bed for years, you know.
Just listen to this, right? It says, constant companions, blah, blah, blah. They have shared in each other's successes and failures. Gary got the 1986 Golden Boot, 2 Footballer of the Year awards, a Cup Winners Cup medal, 80 caps for England and 48 goals for his country. Willie is a former winner of the Mercantile Credit.
What's on the telly? Oh, it's that Gary Lineker crisps advert.
Hold on a minute.
I hope someday you'll be together, singing these words with all your heart.
You've done brilliant this time. You've got them little strands and everything, that's perfect.
I'm completely gelled up as well, just like him off the telly.
Yeah, that is very good. So, what, have you been playing any snooker? I suppose this morning, perhaps you was in a tournament.
Yes. Yes, I managed to lose actually in the second round this time.
The second round?
Well, you're coming on. I've improved around.
But, well, who could. Who could that be? Kids, you know, messing about. They're always playing.
I'm Willie Thorne.
Well, you better sit over there on the Willie Thorne settee.
Willie, what I've done is I've gone out and I've come back. I've come back dressed as that bloke from The Bill.
Oh yeah.
How was you? Actually, no, I'm sorry. I am you. I am you. Yeah.
The moustache is good.
Is it?
Yeah. You've got a bit more hair than me at the back though.
What do you think? What if I go and miss an easy red? Will that?
Just like me. Just like me.
Lovely to see you, Willie.
Nice tie. Nice jacket.
Yeah, no, it's lovely.
Almost knew what I was going to wear, didn't you?
Well, I just guessed, you know. I've been studying you for a long time. I've guessed. So, Willie, it's very, very difficult. The worst of it is the shine you've got on here. That's very, very difficult
to
get.
Well, I gel it.
Do you?
Absolutely. It's sticky when you gel it, and it stays in exactly the same place.
I've noticed that, actually.
No, I've got 8 hairs here, and I have to get them exactly straight when I go on the TV.
8 hairs? You know? Is that one for every round of the World Championship you've ever been in?
Sorry, Willie. I've been a pro a long time.
Shouldn't there be a row of library books between you two?
So, don't forget then, this week's competition, your chance to win an Enzy League T-shirt, £1 worth of premium bond, or VIP tickets to any game of your choice at Barnsley. All you have to do is pick our goal of the month. as an E. As a B. Or as a C. Okay, now, as you know, the players this weekend are on their New Year's break, so there isn't actually...
Say, it's the FA Cup.
Well, I'll just tick the ITV schedules. No, it isn't.
What is it? That is it.
No, Jimmy. Okay. We'll talk about the FA Cup.
Thank goodness for that. We couldn't go on like that, Saint.
Okay, well, let's start by taking a look at the latest betting.
Actually, Vinnie Jones, you know, Vinnie Jones famously involved in that incident where he bit off that interviewer's nose. But what a lot of people don't know is that during the interview beforehand, that interviewer was deliberately trying to wind him up.
So, Russell, on the subject of astrology, which is a fascinating thing, you're right, it is my birthday on tomorrow, actually. Do you have any idea what the future has in
yes,
store?
Yes, I have. I've got it all down here. Well, I think the most interesting aspect... Oh, look.
We've got tea leaves on it as well.
Yes.
Two fortunes for the price of one. Fantastic.
Well, you've got a very, very good aspect here, Frank, coming up for the next 7 years, in fact. And basically, your whole world is going to change upside down. It's going to be a bit like Eric Cantona's, actually.
Really?
No, there's some very good aspects here. And I think also you're going to go through a period as well where love and relationships...
You're right, my world is going to turn upside down. Oh, I'm sorry, Russell, because I am interested.
Frank, but I knew I shouldn't have done this.
Oh, no, don't say.
No, it's all right, I don't mind. I'm used to this. My shoulders are broad enough, go on, and your stomach's big enough.
Well, I certainly wouldn't say that, for goodness sake.
You said it to Joe Brand last week, though, poor cow. Anyway.
I thought this was Joe Brand.
You bought... Edie from Norwich. This is brilliant, isn't it? That is it, Darren Edie. His name is. And surely that he's a cleaning woman, isn't he, with a name like Edie?
No, he just appealed, didn't he?
Because I was thinking, if you had Edie and you had May in your defence, and you had Flo, you could build a team of cleaning.
Hello, Ronald. Welcome to Fantasy Football League. Is this your first speaking part on British TV?
Oh, no. I was a lot of on TV when I was a kid.
Really?
Yeah. Don't you remember? The Milky Bars are on me.
Right, now, we're here to recreate that moment in the World Cup qualifier, England versus Holland, when David Platt was racing into the box and you sort of tackled...
You mean when I should have been sent off?
Well, yeah. You realise, Ronald, that after that incident, you know, it got a bit ridiculous. People in England started to blame you for everything that had ever gone wrong with English football.
No, trust me. Nobody will laugh at you, Mr. Venison.
So I think what we need to do is to make the cup final more popular, more accessible, more fun.
I know just a man. Hello. Can you get me Tom Webster?
Oh, God, dear. What are we gonna do, Laurie?
Smith. Alan Smith.
I know. I'll bring on Alan Smith. For Lineker.
Did it, that?
That'll really upset some people.
I felt a bit sorry to Graham Taylor in the World Cup game. He was trying England to play skillfully. Mm. Even Tony Adams was hitting the ball outside of his feet. for tearing up Graham Taylor with his Victor Meldrew impression, no?
Ah, I don't believe it.
So, what do you remember about the Platt incident?
No, it was a long pass of any sentence towards to our box, and I was a little bit behind David Platt, and I was pulling him on his arm, on his shirt, and the first pulling, I think it was outside of the area, and what's happened? No, everybody.
Yeah. Okay. Well, tell you what, Frank, you're Andy Sinton.
Okay.
No, no, no. You don't understand. You are Andy Sinton. Look at this.
Okay, I'm Andy Sinton.
Right, well, okay, I'll be David Platt and you be Ronald Koeman.
Okay, play Eddie Poelman.
Kamp graag wil komen. En nu, geen buitenspel. Platt. Het is er buiten. Maar als een makker.
Right! Obstruction!
So why do you think you weren't sent off?
Oh, it was ITN's fault. The newsreader Trevor McDonald was a big Holland fan. Mm. And so he stole the referee's red card, I think.
Yeah, yeah, well, it's all right joking, Ronald, but the fact is you are a villain. It's because of you that that team never got to represent England in the World Cup.
Yeah, and because of you, there were no English fans at USA 94.
Yeah, yeah, and because of you, Graham Taylor got the sack. Yay! Are you a drink?
Do I not like orange?
So, Gary, we're here to recreate that terrible moment in the 1992 European Championships when you got pulled off by... I can't say pulled off. I can't say pulled off. Taken off.
Well, I think it was the best goal I've ever seen, but that I do support West Brom.
As an 18th century West Country serving wench turned up.
I thought the first line was actually correct, and then suddenly.
I just put a West Brom. Well, you should know if you want to.
Don't confuse him.
Sorry. Sorry.
You've cracked.
Sorry. Right, well, Dina, thanks very much for turning up today.
And let me handle this. Perché non c'è mai vita sulla finestra, Fernando Branca, Parmigiano Reggiano, I salite dei Italo Nasti, Parma Club Fienze, e Termoplastica Nevienze.
Ma questo è matto, non capisce niente, è matto.
Okay. Well, I feel a bit insulted.
Action. You should all run in with this, it looks like a free kick. Tell him English players are faster, they would have caught it.
Dites-les joueurs anglais sont plus rapides.
Yes, surtout. Speed. Stand by then and action.
No! Yes! 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 You've done it! Yes!
Keep it going! Keep it going!
You should be down, right?
right, so I should be warm.
All right, then, let's do it. I'll be Stuart Pearce, who took the free kick. Frank, you be Gary Pallister, who nodded across the goal. And you be Dennis Wise.
OK, play Derby.
I've got to look at the camera and say it.
Let's take the camera.
Play Derby.
That'll be in the outtakes.
All right, off you go.
Chapman, off you go.
Chapman,
off yourselves if you want guys.
Hold on, now you're tickling me there.
Sorry.
I left a bit further up than that.
Further up or further down?
Further down, obviously, will be fine, but
if you reach
further up's probably cleverer.
No, just a joke.
Yes,
off.
I am, yeah.
Just
yeah,
a joke. No, just trying to get into it. Just a joke.
If you could beam in even lower.
Thank you.
Thank you. Speak. Looking over this way.
Oh, God, dear. What are we going to do, Laurie?
Alan Smith.
I know. I'll bring on Alan Smith. For Lineker.
Lineker? That'll really upset some people.
You're right, Laurie.
Yes,
we're doing
the accent.
Alden, did you say bullocks? Bollocks or bullocks?
Bollocks with ball.
Bollocks.
Bullocks or bollocks?
No, bollocks.
Bollocks, second one.
The second you said one. Bullocks.
I did say bullocks.
No, so bollocks. Isn't that the right word?
What's no, it's bollocks.
Bollocks?
Bollocks.
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 Bollocks. Bollocks.
Yes. That's it, perfect. You just sound incredibly English for that one word. I love that.
Bollocks. <It's> okay. Bollocks.
Okay.
What a funny word. Here we go. What does it mean?
It means testicles.
Oh, fuck. Yes! Yes! Yes!
About football trophies is you shouldn't wash them at too high a temperature. I mean, look at that. They could at least have hand-washed the European Cup.
I like this sports camera. There's lots of very interesting things. There's a photo of Arsenal's team that won the FA Cup in 1950. And here's the League Cup, or, well, Littlewood's Cup, Rumbler's Cup, now the Coca-Cola Cup, of course, where the holders are Liverpool. Nice trophy, that one.
Hold on a minute, Cyril Knowall. Tell me this, then, here's a quiz question. Name the players who've scored in both the FA Cup final and the League Cup final.
Well, there was Peter McFarlane, there was Bobby Tamplin, there was Peter Osgood, there was Andy Gray, there was Norman Whiteside, there was Brian McClare, Mark Hughes and Ian Rush.
Ah, you see, there is one more.
One more?
You know we belong together, you and I forever and ever, no matter where you are, you're my guiding star. And from the very first moment I saw you, I've never felt such emotion. I'm walking on air. Just to know you are there. Hold me in your arms, don't let me go. I want to stay forever, home and away, with you each day. Let me be the one that you turn to, someone you can rely on closer each day. Home and